Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, I am going to talk about this project ImHex. I have no idea how it's meant to be pronounced, and I don't have any affiliation with this project at all. They are not sponsoring me or anything like that. This is an open source project, and I just thought it was cool, and coincidentally, it is written in C++, and you can tell by the interface, it probably uses DRM GUI, which is probably related to the name of it. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains. Today we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes filling this need its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactorings, and a wide range of tools into your day-to-day development. The latest version of CLion introduces deep integrations with the ReSharper C++ Writer C++ language engine, performance improvements for the debugger, new features for embedded development, and enhancements for project models and build tools. Use the code CPPWeeklyCLion to get 25% off when purchasing a new CLion subscription or renewing your existing one. And before I get going, I do, of course, want to remind you that I'm available for code reviews, on-site training. You should definitely have me out to your organization. And, well, we can just talk about this fun tool now. Now, this is a hex editor, and it is an extraordinarily full-featured hex editor that can recognize all kinds of different file formats, and it can break things down for you, and it's got data inspectors, and I have the GUI zoomed at a 2x right now, just so you know, so that it's at least a little bit visible to you. The normal thing is far too small for it to have made sense for a YouTube video. Just has so many ridiculous tools built into it. So if you open, for example, this PNG file, it's going to ask you, hey, do you want me to parse this thing as a PNG file? Yes, I would like you to do that, please. And then you have all these resizable, dockable windows and such. You can actually click through and visualize the data structures that are inside of this PNG file, which is just, it's just super cool. So we can see the header starts with the value 137 and then has the literal 3-byte string PNG, which I think is required for a PNG file to be recognized. And then you've got all these cool color syntax highlighting deals. So if I click on the orange here, then I can see the orange here and mouse over the things that were parsed out. And for any selected range of values, it'll tell me all of the different things that that might be, if it were a string or an RGB color or a GUID or a floating point value or whatever. And then it has all these crazy like calculators and graphing calculators, and just in case you wanted a color picker to change the color of some pixel in some image that you had updated or something like that. LLVM demangler, so if we have any mangled names on here, then we can put those in there. ASCII character chart, right? It's just randomness. There's so many things in here, and it has achievements, and it has its own like tutorial tool built into it. It's just nuts. And I'm going to try opening a file I haven't opened yet. All right, let's see what we got here. This was not recognized as any particular type of file, but if I'm right, this might be something that we can actually look at here. So byte swapper, base converters, Unix permission calculator, because of course, we have here the disassembler, and you can select which region of the binary that you want to disassemble, and you can select which type of architecture you want to disassemble. So of course, we have to try the MOS Technology 65XX disassembler. Let's hit disassemble and see what we got. Oh, there it is. It's just squished down at the bottom here. Might be a downside to having the UI zoomed 2x here. I don't really see a good way to get this disassembly expanded, unfortunately. But you can see that it is capable of doing the disassembly of a bunch of different architectures as well. It has this data flow processor. You can do things like have it take chunks of the binary and connect them together in like a data flow diagram, and it can do arithmetic and all of the decoding and visualization. Like, you can have it actually interpret some of these bytes as an image to display those. It's super, super cool. It's free, it's open source, it's available on whatever platform you're using, and it's written in C++. If you have any interest at all in playing with a tool like this or contributing to it, I just suggest that you check this thing out because it's super neat. I guess that's where I'll leave this episode. So thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed this kind of little tool spotlight where I got a little excited about this tool here. Leave a comment. Let me know if you want to see random things like this again in the future. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next episode.